First question. Okay, I have a function here. I have a function here. Tan of pi into gif of x minus pi by 1 plus gif of x cos square. Discuss the differentiability of this function. Discuss means I am opening it. The entire real number. Tell me the points where the function will be non-differentiable. JEE function gives you the greatest integer less than equal to that number. Let's say GIF of 3.5, that's 3. JEE of 10.7, that's 10. JEE of minus 4.2 is minus 5. Yes. You know, this question is worth 5 seconds.
So between minus 1 and...
It's just 5 seconds. This question is just worth 5 seconds.
So is it between minus 1 and 0?
Minus 1 and 0 is completely undefined.
So is it just...
So it's not
tan function is not defined. This is not tan x actually. It's complicated.
Tan y.
5 seconds. Tick tick 1. Tick tick 2. Huh? Dhruv, what do you think? How many of you are scared of mod function and JEE function? Raise your
hand.
Why? Why you don't stand? You know the definition of it, right? JEE means the greatest integer less than or equal to that number. What's there to be scared about? Mod function is something which makes that particular function give a positive output. What's there to be scared about? You're not thinking hard enough. GIF, the name itself says greatest integer it will return which is less than that number. So do you think that this number would always be an integer or not?
Yeah.
And integral multiple of pi is always? This is a zero function. Denominator is safe because it will never be zero. Numerator will always be zero. So it's a zero function. See how you can be tricked. Denominator will never be zero, that's fine. Numerator is always tan of an integral multiple of pi. Remember, tan pi is 0, tan 1 pi, tan 2 pi is 0, tan 3 pi is 0, tan minus pi is 0.
N pi.
Tan n pi is 0. Because sin n pi is 0. Correct? So this function is differentiable everywhere. Everywhere. It is a straight line on the x-axis itself. It's just the fear in your mind that overcomes you. Can I take the next question? This set is zero. Next. If f of x is defined as x e to the power negative 1 by mod x.
So is it x into?
See, the world is like that. The more you are scared of something, the more world will scare you. That's the rule of life, not only mathematics. So don't be scared of anything. Overcome that fear. So this is a function f of x which follows this definition when x is not equal to 0. and is 0 when x is equal to 0. Options. Option A. This function is continuous and differentiable for all x. And I say for all x means all x belonging to real numbers. Option B. It is continuous for all x. It is continuous for all x. But not differentiable at x equal to 0. Please don't plot it, because you know in competitive exams you will not be given that phone in your hand. Is differentiable but not continuous at x equal to 0. Isn't this a weird option? How can it be differentiable but not continuous?
Not continuous.
So we can cross it.
I'm not writing C.
None of you. Think properly, then answer. Which is the only point of contention here?
Zero.
So just check continuity at 0, just check differentiability at 0.
You won't be
differentiable.
So you say option B.
1 minute.
Okay?
1 minute. And when x is greater than 0,
it will be x into the power minus 2 by x. Okay. Left hand limit at 0 is 0. Right hand limit is what?
It's 0.
Sure.
Yeah. No. Yeah. Right hand limit.
What is the limit x tending to 0 plus x e to the power minus 2 by x? 0.
Yeah.
What this disturb you?
X is as it is tending to 0.
Zero, yeah.
It is not zero exactly, to be very frank here. It is a quantity which is very, very small and positive.
So take an even smaller quantity will be almost tending to zero, even more than that.
His reasoning is this quantity will be smaller, very small quantity. Why? Because it is e to the power negative infinity, which is actually 1 by e to the power infinity, correct?
Yeah.
Now this quantity has its modulus lesser than 1. So if you raise such a quantity to a very, very high power, this will start going towards 0. This is also going towards 0. So both of them are becoming very small and hence the answer is 0. Okay? The problem would have arisen if one were going to 0 and another were going to infinity. Then it would lead to another indeterminate form. That's actually infinity into 0 form. That would require a separate treatment. But here, he's absolutely correct that the answer is going to be 0. So left hand limit, right hand limit and the value of the function at 0, all are 0. Hence it is continuous at 0. So that's the bad news for me because I have to do the differentiability test then. Correct? Had it been discontinuous at x equal to 0, our work would have got over, right? But unfortunately now we have to do the differentiability test at 0. So how will I do that? Simple. Differentiate the function left to 0. Differentiate the function right to 0. Put x as 0. Left to 0, if you differentiate, you're going to get 1. So I can say L f dash 0 is what? 1. Okay? No need to use first principles for this. Second one, R f dash 0. Now if you differentiate it, we have to use product rule. So I can say e to the power negative 2 by x plus x e to the power negative 2 by x into 2 by x squared, right? Now because of this x which is remaining over here, and x tends to 0 plus, you can say, this entire thing will become what? What will happen to this entire thing?
It will be quite a big number? Yes.
Sure?
X is 0, it will become
undefined, yes.
Yes.
Right? So in this case, it will become? Correct. So in this case, we can say it is not differentiable at x equal to 0, but it was continuous everywhere. Because once you cross that critical point, it is all made up of continuous functions. So it has to be continuous everywhere, but not differentiable at x equal to 0. Has anybody tried plotting the graph of this?
Yeah.
Was it almost like this?
I mean, I don't know how to plot exactly the same.
Yes?
How do you do
it? Was it like that, Tejas?
Yes, I'm doing it.
Okay. Next question. Sure. Yeah, right. See, he is on the graph. Sir? Yes.
But like I have to do the other random number.
Huh?
I don't know how to get into the other random number.
What is there, no?